Hi, and welcome to the AYTM.com Survey Editor tutorial. Today, I'll show you how to write and program elegant and effective online surveys using our state-of-the-art survey authoring tools. This is an overview demo to show you the main controls and layout of our survey editor. If you're looking for a specific tutorial on one of our question types or advanced functionalities, please check the corresponding video in our resources video library. Unlike many survey programming tools, you can see your entire survey on one page. This matters because it makes it easier to keep the whole survey layout in front of you and saves you tons of time because you don't have to open each question separately, edit it, then save and close it before you can move on. The main title field is not visible for respondents. You may have already assigned a name to the survey earlier on the target market page. If not, you can adjust it here. This title is for your internal purposes. It'll help you locate the survey in the dashboard, share it, and export it, so don't worry about exposing the purpose of your study, client name, or any other technical information. There is a second optional title field below. This one is visible to respondents. Be careful not to reveal something about the target audience or sample requirement here to ensure that you get the most relevant responses. By default, you'll get three single-choice placeholder questions. This is the minimum number of questions required to launch a survey on AYTM, but they don't all have to be single-choice. In fact, you can quickly change the type of any question by clicking on its icon in the upper left corner of the question field. We'll get back to the question type options in a bit. Great, but what if I need to start with an open-ended question? As it turns out, I don't have to start over or convert the first question if it's already written out. See these gray handles on the right of each field? You can use them to easily reorder your questions. I'm going to drag and drop this open-ended question to the top and put the single-choice question on the bottom. You may have noticed a black pop-up on the left that appeared as I was moving my questions. It's a little trick that allows you to save time by cloning a question instead of creating it from scratch. To clone, simply hold the Command key on a Mac or the Control key on a PC as you drag your question until you see the plus icon in the pop-up, and don't release the key until you've moved your cloned question into your chosen spot. Please note that all your text, images, and other settings associated with the question will be cloned as well. I'm going to add a few answer choices for questions 3 and 4 simply by clicking the plus button below them. The text will give you a clear idea of how many more answer choices you can add. We always recommend keeping a survey as short as possible, so think about the limits that you see here as a safety net and a guideline for creating the best survey-taking experience on the web and mobile devices alike. That said, we have a few subscription options that raise the limits for professional researchers. Please ping us if you need more. Another quality assurance safety net we've implemented has to do with the number of characters in questions and answers. When you click on a field, you'll notice a character counter appears in the right corner of the field. It'll keep track of how many characters you have remaining as you type, and give you enough space for most research needs. After all, no one likes to read a whole book in a survey, and you want to focus respondents' attention on what's most important without making them fall asleep. Please note how I just pasted a list of pre-written answer choices from a document into the first answer field, and they automatically populated the answer fields, saving me a lot of time. Now let's take a look at the sidebar. It's a handy set of controls and survey information that will follow you as your survey gets longer. That way, you'll always know the cost of your survey, which may change as you add more time-consuming questions. It also gives you quick access to all question types and research tests, as well as the global survey controls. If you made a mistake, simply press Command-Z on a Mac or Control-Z on a PC to undo, or click the left arrow. Press Command-Y on a Mac or Control-Y on a PC, or the right arrow, to redo. By the way, Adobe users will appreciate that the Command-Shift-Z or Control-Shift-Z keyboard shortcut is also supported for redo in our survey editor. We recommend saving your survey often. You can do that by clicking the disk icon in the sidebar, the large Save button on the bottom of the page, or simply by pressing Command-S on a Mac or Control-S on a PC. After a quick refresh, you'll see the confirmation pop up. I'll get back to the Share, Print, and Preview features a little later. For now, I'd like to walk you through the categories of questions that we offer. I'm opening a pre-written survey with a bunch of examples. Each of them was carefully selected, designed, and implemented to provide the best possible insights for you, as well as a smooth, engaging experience for survey takers. As you roll over the question icons in the sidebar, you'll see category names appear above. Single-choice radio buttons, multiple-choice checkboxes, and open-ended question types are in the Simple Questions category. You'll likely use them the most often, as they are clear and flexible for most cases in online surveys. Here we have examples of a single choice question, a multiple choice question, and an open-ended question. The second category is context questions. They're not really questions per se, because respondents have no way of answering them, but it's the best way to expose them to your stimuli, such as video clips or images, instructions, or copy that you want to test. Here we have examples of instruction text, an image question, and a video question. The third group of questions are in the matrix category. It's a fantastic way to group similar questions together in one. It's more time-consuming for respondents than simple questions, but way better than if each question were presented separately. It'll save you money and respondents time by keeping answer options consistent across several sub-questions you want to ask. In this category, we have sliders, star ratings, and smiley ratings. The fourth group gives you a few advanced options. It consists of a ranking or reorder question, where respondents drag and drop a list of items in the order of their preference, combo box for long single-choice lists, such as a list of countries, and the cascade, a simple way to present a huge tree-structured database into a series of 2 to 4 nested combo boxes. A popular example is choosing the make, year, model, and trim of a vehicle, which you've probably seen before. Finally, we have the research tests category. These are more than questions, because they will be presented to respondents in a way that would support various smart research methodologies, number crunch the responses in a very sophisticated way, and provide you with full analysis. In this category, we have the distribute question type, with constant and continuous sum, the price sensitivity meter, or Van Westendorp test, side-by-side comparison, and an advanced max diff. Each question type is a separate topic, and we encourage you to watch corresponding tutorials which are available right from this page as you roll over questions in the dialog box. If you prefer to read about them and see examples of how questions look in the editor or the actual survey, and what to expect on the stats page when data is collected, please check out our question types section. We always recommend previewing your survey several times before you launch. We have a very handy feature for previewing your survey right here on this page. Just click Preview in the sidebar. You can see the survey the way respondents will see it, without the ability to go back and change answers and so forth. If it would take too long to preview your entire survey in respondent mode, you can instantly switch to researcher mode. Now you can jump to any question in the survey, ignore skip logic, and keep the next button on without having to fill out every question. When adding a question, you have 3 options. First, you can click on the icon that represents a question type you want to add. That will add the new question in the center of your screen, and you can drag it up or down to your chosen position. Second, you can drag the question type icon itself from the sidebar and paste it in the exact spot where you need it. Third, you can scroll down to the end of the survey and click here to add a new question. This dialog box is the same as the one I showed you for changing question types. Please note that beyond 10 included simple questions, each question has a different cost associated with it. We value respondents' time and have to make their incentives appropriate for the time it'll take them to answer your survey thoughtfully. Please note that there are 3 things that you add differently from the rest of your survey questions. One item is a pre-screener, or prequalification, that lets only relevant people into the survey. If they don't pass the prequal, they don't get to see your survey, and you don't pay for their answers. A prequal may be added by using one of our house tags on the target market page. Another item you add differently is a custom prequalification, which you create if you need a market niche that goes beyond our house tags. Custom prequals function the same way as our regular prequals, except you create the wording for your particular targeting needs. The third type is video response. You can start your survey with a prompt to record a webcam response, or finish the survey with it. Either way, you get an excellent qualitative layer of insights that will put a face to your data, allowing you to gauge emotional feedback from facial expressions and gestures, and gain valuable glimpses into consumers' daily environments. I'll cover each of these question types separately in other tutorials. Let's talk about a few more advanced features. Researchers often want answer choices or sub-questions to be presented in a random order to respondents to avoid order bias, like when the first item in a list is rated higher or attracts more attention just because it's presented first to everyone. To prevent that, you can enable global survey randomization. Once it's switched on, you'll see gray anchor icons next to each field on the right, allowing you to anchor or lock the position of any item that you want excluded from global randomization. This is very useful for keeping answers like none of the above or other, please specify, as the last answer option in a list. This also works well for scaled types of answers like strongly disagree, somewhat disagree, neutral, somewhat agree, and strongly agree that logically must remain in this order. Speaking of other, please specify, please note the little talking cloud icon in the right side of answer fields. By clicking on it, you enable an optional text input field that respondents may use to fill in their own answer. Reality is usually larger than our expectations. You'd be surprised what respondents come up with. Skip logic is another feature easily available in the editor. It allows you to ask relevant questions based on earlier answers and set up A-B or monadic studies, exposing respondents only to one of several alternative stimuli, such as product shots, prices, or video commercials. Just click on the little bunny rabbits and set it up in minutes. We offer direct skip logic and random skip logic with organic or even distribution. Watch the separate video here to learn more. Researchers often like to illustrate their questions and answers. In this example, we've added illustrations of different vacation destinations to evoke relevant memories in respondents and make it more fun for them to take the survey. Illustrations may be the object of your research when testing new logos or ads. You can upload and attach an image to most questions or answers and make it appear as a thumbnail or much larger and prominently featured. Last but not least, let's take a look at the sidebar one more time. Here you'll find the target icon, allowing you to quickly check your order details without loading the target market page. By the way, if you do want to adjust your targeting, save your survey, and then click the Edit Target Market button on the top of the sidebar. It's always a good idea to have someone take a look at your survey before you launch it, and it's often a requirement to get your survey approved by a client or internal decision maker. Use the Share icon here to send a survey draft via email, or simply copy the preview link and text it to the reviewer. We recommend sending a survey draft to yourself first and then forwarding it from your mailbox. That way, it's sent from your address, which ensures that you'll get their reply. You can easily print out your draft by clicking the print icon. For a greener option, you can also print a PDF. When you're happy with your draft and ready to launch, click Checkout. We'll instantly provide you with an automatic error check to make sure there are no empty fields or conflicts in your skip logic. If there is a problem, you'll see it reported on the bottom and highlighted with color in the survey. After a quick fix, you'll be ready to launch your survey, sit back, and start seeing your results streaming in. And there you have it, a super powerful yet friendly and intuitive survey editor. At this point, I recommend checking out our stats report videos or diving into the specific question type tutorials. Thanks again for watching, and feel free to ping us for assistance or to set up a personal demo.